Our next honoree tonight is our Senior Player of the Year on the men's side, Mr. Mike McCoy from Norwalk. This is the third time Mike's won the Senior Player of the Year award. It'll tag team with the 11 times he's won the Regular Player of the Year award, so pretty darn impressive when you start stacking up those numbers. Mike won the R&A Seniors Amateur this year. He qualified for match play at two USGA championships, including a run to the round of 16 at the US Senior Amateur. Also finished in the top five of the Herman Sani Tournament on the senior side. Mike, of course, a video. We'll show that one.
Mike McCoy has a nickname that some golfers use when describing his golf exploits. The Lion. The Lion roared again in 2022. Early in the year, Mike was named captain of the 2023 Walker Cup team, which will play for the Walker Cup at the home of golf, St. Andrews in Scotland. Being named captain of America's Walker Cup team puts Mike in the pantheon of amateur golf, alongside other past captains named Bob Jones, Francis Ouimet, Charles Coe, Nathaniel Crosby, and Fred Ridley, current chairman of Augusta National. This incredible achievement was richly deserved, based on Mike's singular playing record through the years and many contributions to the game. It may be the highest honor ever bestowed on an amateur golfer in Iowa history. Perhaps the captaincy inspired him, because Mike soon thereafter captured one of the greatest victories of his career, the British Senior Amateur Championship held at Royal Darnock in Scotland. Mike dominated the field over 4 days and at one time held a 12-shot lead during the fourth round. This career achievement equals his tremendous victory at the United States Mid-Amateur in 2013. Mike tends to underplay his accomplishments, but even he admitted that his breathtaking 69 carted in gale force winds during the third round of the British Senior Amateur was one of the greatest rounds of his storied golf career. Knowing Mike, this season was made more special by the fact that his son Nate also had an awesome season. To our knowledge, a father and son have never before won Player of the Year honors in the same year. Before we conclude, I think some general remarks about Mike's golfing life are in order. As we reflect on Mike's long golf career, we can say this: defeat and disappointment have spurred him on to do amazing things. He's not satisfied now with a pretty good shot or a top 10 finish. He strives to be perfect. That's the way a great artist must feel. Regarding Mike as a human being, what was said about Bobby Jones applies just as perfectly to Mike McCoy. His gift to his friends is the warmth that comes from unselfishness, his superb judgment, his nobility of character, and his unwavering loyalty to principle. What Mike has done for our state is to create a model that everyone, consciously or unconsciously, tries to follow. He has been a beacon of light for Iowa golf, and one of the reasons why we have so many fine people involved in golf in our great state. Mike shows us how to do it. Congratulations on a great 2022.
Before we hand the mic over to you, Mike, a couple couple of things. One, we have a last year, if you guys attended, we gave a little special gift to Gene Elliott when he won the USGA Senior Amateur. Well, Mike won the British Senior Amateur this year, which Gene won last year too. And Mike, through the help of your wife, Tina, we were able to gather a few things and put this together that we're gonna present to you tonight. Maybe you'll throw it on display so people can take a look, but it's got the flag, it's got his scorecards up here, it's got the medal, gold medal he's got framed up for him. It's kind of a testament to the you know, awesome achievement it is to win that British Senior Amateur. And I find it funny that you had to go all the way to Scotland when all Gene had to do was walk across the street to give me the trophy. So that's pretty cool to think about. Also, you know, this is the 2023 Walker Cup captain. We've had one ever in Iowa before. In 1975, Dr. Ed Updegraff was the Walker Cup captain. He's from Boone originally. So second one ever, which, you know, for having two of those in our little old state again. And I mentioned it earlier, but having Zach as the Ryder Cup captain, man, 2023 is going to be awesome. So good luck over there. Good luck picking the team. It's going to be a lot of work for you, I know, and busy time, but on behalf of Iowa and the whole U.S., go kick some butt.
That's very nice. I really appreciate it, and I will always have a lot of appreciation. So thanks, Jeff. Anyway, this is a great night. I'm really here because I'm awfully proud of Nate. This award was very important to me when I was younger. And, you know, you'd set the goal and you'd figure out your schedule and how are you going to do it. And back in the day, they announced the winner on Christmas morning in the Des Moines Register, and Rick would write that article. And I still remember a few of those Christmases when I was Player of the Year, and that was pretty special. And it's nice that we can do it together, and you know, I appreciate everybody coming out, and want to congratulate, you know, all the other award winners. You know, very inspirational, and you know, we're in a good state. Golf's probably people have underestimated Iowa golfers, and surprising the world. And you know, I'll share with you just a couple of thoughts on the Walker Cup. My wife and I, Tana, have been out watching a lot of golf. I thought that was going to be what I was going to be spending most of my time, is watching and watching these young players. And you know, it's pretty nerve-wracking when you start thinking about, well, you're either going to win or lose, and you're going all the way to St. Andrews, and you know, it's you know, you begin to feel the pressure. And but the more I get out and watch these players, the better I feel, because, you know, there's a lot of talented golfers that not just in this room, but all across the country. And so we'll have a good team. We'll make it real special, and you know, hopefully you'll be able to follow us and cheer us on. I've got my mom here. she's been a great supporter. And I've got another good friend here, Doug Scholl. For years, Doug caddied for me. Doug had a little airplane, and he had a pilot. And we would fly to the Storm Lake for the Lake Creek Amateur, and or Spencer, or wherever, you know, Clinton. And I felt like Arnold Palmer, you know, I didn't have to get out of this little plane, and we'd go play, and Doug would caddy, and we had a lot of fun, and those are good memories, and I appreciate you coming tonight, Doug. So with that, I'll conclude, but I sure appreciate all your support, and we'll try and make everybody proud next year.